Your love, the power of your love. else's passion. I don't wanna find that I'm just dry bones. I wanna burn with unquenchable fire. Deep down inside, see it coming alive. I don't wanna ride for somebody else's passion. I don't wanna find that I'm just dry bones. I wanna burn with unquenchable fire. Deep down inside, see it coming alive.
Help me find my own flame. we bring an anthem to you tonight. We sound an anthem saying that you are worthy. You're worthy. Forever in the day. We thank you for your presence here tonight, Lord. We ask you to fill this room. Shift into a time of singing intercession from the Word. I invite everyone here to open their Bibles to Psalm 65 as we sing intercession in the Word. Psalm 65. We will read out the scriptures and sing out our intercession over Korea. As we pray and sing out scripture, let's remember the power of God's eternal Word. That it is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing to the division of soul and of spirit, of joints and of marrow, and discerning the thoughts and intentions of the heart. No creature is hidden from its sight. It never returns void. And when we speak it out, we are claiming the truth of God that will go forth. So let us enter into a place to receive God's heart for Korea tonight. And let us pray back his heart to him. You care for the land and water it. You enrich it abundantly. The streams of God are filled with water to provide the people with grain, for so you have ordained it. God, you are the abundant provider who tends the land and who provides for your people. You have always watched over Korea in the good times and the bad. When Korea was ravished by war, when it was choked and suffocated by invasion, you were there. You have wept over this land. You have cared for it. You have watered it, revived it. And above all, you sent your son to die for your people in this land. With each passing year and season you have taken this nation through, you have ordained your goodness to overwhelm your people. We speak out your blessing as you enrich your people abundantly. Your streams of living water have never run dry, and you continue to send forth water for both the physical body as well as for the soul and spirit. So water your people here tonight, Lord. Water the land of Korea. Fill them with your presence and refresh their souls.
This land with
Drenches the furrows. You drench your people with your spirit and do not hold back. You are the God who levels the ridges of the trenches for planting. You prepare the hearts of your people for the planting of your word so it may take root. You are the God who softens the ground with rain. You soften the hearts of your people with showers of your goodness and blessing. You are the God who blesses the crops of the land. You bless your people. We speak these promises over Korea. Drench this land and this people with your spirit. Level and soften their hearts. Level and soften their hearts so they may receive your word. Shower your goodness on the Korean people and bless them tonight, Lord.
You satisfy our souls. fresh wind is here. Coming of the fresh rain is here. Coming of the fresh sunshine over this land is here. Oh, it's here. Coming of the fresh wind is here. Coming of the fresh rain is here. Coming of the fresh sunshine is here over this land. Fresh rain is here. Coming of the fresh sunshine is here. Over this land, over this land. Indeed, old is gone and the new has come. Old is gone and the new has come. Old is gone and the new has come. Gone and the new has come. We sing, old is gone and the new has come. 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 Old is gone and the new. Old has gone and the new has come. Old has gone and the new has come. Old has gone and the new has come. Ooh. Oh. I see his promise over this land. Indeed, he's bringing a fresh wind and fire, setting everything ready to go.
With your bounty, and your carts overflow with abundance. Lord, you have crowned this year with your bounty. Your generosity is beyond measure. You have caused Korea to overflow with abundance. Your love encircles the year as with a crown, giving each day pearls of your goodness. Your unceasing kindness and providence makes a complete circuit, surrounding the year with your presence. And so it is with Korea, for you fill her carts to overflow. You have not forgotten this land or this people. Rather, you have continued to provide with abundance for the needs of your dear Korea. She is yours and yours alone. Crown her Lord. Crown Korea with a year of bounty and cause your goodness to overflow her hearts.
We sing, this nation belongs to you. We sing, this year belongs to you. This nation will be filled with your glory, and your bounty will overflow. This nation will be marked with your bounty. This nation will be marked with your glory. Come Jesus, take your place. Oh Jesus, you like the way things are going, but we wanna see more in Korea. So won't you crown your children with a bounty and their hearts to overflow? Because you give abundantly, give abundantly. Let the children sing to you, and all the elders sing with them too. Of your goodness, of your glory, as they bow down and crash their crowns before.
Thank you.
receive your glory. Oh, this nation belongs to you, Jesus. It belongs to you. Your name, it marks this nation.
Oh, what pleasure you have over this land.
So much pleasure that you're rocking on a rocking chair. You laugh with delights. You laugh with delights. You laugh with delight over your children.
You release joy over this land tonight, Jesus.
Here's the children desperately needed. We sing joy. Oh, we sing joy.
Oh, we sing joy. Oh, we sing joy.
We sing joy. We sing joy. We sing joy. Oh, yeah. Oh, we sing joy. We sing joy. We sing joy.
I feel like tonight, I mean, we have all this like songs that we have set up for to sing after. You know, we have like a certain way we go about prayer watch. But I feel like tonight, God wants to do something new. I don't know what He wants to do, actually. But I just feel that, like, you know, most of the times when we come to an intercessory set, like when we pray, when we say we want to pray for Korea, it's like we come with a bit of a heavy heart, right? But I feel like tonight God wants to release all the joy and delight and pleasure that we personally experience with the Lord. I think God wants to multiply that over this land tonight. So how about we just, we'll have Raymond, our this awesome musician of the Lord, just play the tunes, and we'll just kind of, yeah, we'll just sing. How about just singing joy and releasing that over this nation tonight? Yeah, we'll just take some time to do that.
Joyful I was to know that I was covered and protected. Oh, you are my Father. You are the Father of this nation. Hey, hey, remember the days you took me through from peace, please. I see the clouds going away. Oh, you are taking it away with your hands. The light is shining through, and the light is shining through every corner of this land. Joy be strength, let your delight be poured out, Jesus.
Father, Father, you have been the joy of my heart. Father, my joy, my joy.
can make it new. We know that what has been stolen away, you will restore. My joy, you are my joy, you are my joy. Joy.
Psalm 65, verse 12. The grasslands of the wilderness overflow. The hills are clothed with gladness. Lord, you are the kind of God that not only pours out your goodness on populated areas, but even the most lonely and solitary of souls you will visit with your love. You see everyone, everyone in Korea, even the lone farmers of the countryside. You see their toil and labor and you bless them. You see the birds and the beast and you provide for them. You run your hands along the rivers, the mountains, and the grasslands of Korea, marking them with your abundance and clothing them with gladness. You send forth your grace and mercy, filling the land with salvation and joy. You have not forgotten those in the north. You run your hands across the divided land, passing the DMZ and reaching out to those lone souls who are suffering and lonely. You see them. You see them. You reach your hands out to them and you clothe them with your gladness and goodness. Your hand is wiping away the divide. Your hand is clothing the land with gladness, unity, and love.
Ooh, there is no place where your hand doesn't reach.
No place, no place, no place.
You see every person and you call them precious.
You never overlook.
In every valley you visit them. Nothing is hidden from you.
For see everyone and everything. All who are made in the image of God are seen by you. Every person is crafted by your beautiful design.
Everyone is precious in your eyes, precious in your eyes. Everyone is precious in your eyes, precious in your eyes. Everyone is precious in your eyes. Precious in your eyes. Everyone is precious in your eyes. Precious in your eyes. We sing this. Everyone is precious in your eyes. Precious in your eyes. Everyone is precious in your eyes, precious in your eyes. Everyone is precious in your eyes, precious in your eyes. Everyone is precious in your eyes, precious.
More numerous than the sands of the beach. I have heard they're countless than anything that I'd ever thought. Your eye is on the sparrow.
Your eye is on us tonight.
Your eyes are set with beauty for us. You are beautiful.
You are beautiful, God. You are beautiful, God. You are beautiful, God.
You are beautiful, God. You are
55, verse 13. The meadows are covered with flocks, and the valleys are mantled with grain. They shout for joy and sing. Lord, you have blessed Korea and covered her meadows with flocks. You have filled her valleys with grain. Let the bounty of God cause Korea to be vocal with praise. Let Korea lift up shouts of joy and praise. Let the shouts of praise bring down the high places of idol worship in Korea. Cause the rejoicing of your people to shake the land and bring forth more men and women who want to praise you, the one true God. Purge the land of its idolatry through the shouts of praise and singing. You are a bountiful God, and you have blessed your people. Let them shout with joy.
Stay silent anymore. I must sing to Jesus. Let them lift up their voices and shout for joy and sing. Shout it out from all of my heart. Sound of heaven and sing a hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
God, you have washed over this land tonight as we have sung, as we have prayed. God, that your word rings true today, that it is everlasting, that these words and these songs don't fall to the ground, but Lord, that you're bringing a fresh joy to this land, that you're bringing a fresh grace to this land, and that high places are coming down, and that worship is going up to you tonight. We thank you, Lord.
There's a light drawing near. We'll displace all your fears. Brilliant as the sun, it won't delay. Perfect love is on its way. Anything. There's
Of intimacy and even that place of joy that we've experienced tonight as we intercede on these different topics. As I pray, I ask that you stand in agreement with me, knowing that God takes this seriously, and that He is faithful to the end. What He has started in the Korean church, He will finish. So even though we'll be praying for some things that are heavy, we have the joy of the Lord and we know the end. We know that He is faithful, that He will bring this to pass, and that His will be done. And so as we pray tonight, stay in that place of authority and knowing who God is and knowing who you are in God. Lord, you have surely caused your goodness to flow in the nation of Korea. There is a great spiritual legacy and inheritance that the past forefathers have left for your people today. Tonight, we remember the work of the past missionaries and those who have gone before us in obedience to you. We remember Horace Allen, John Ross, Ruby Kendrick, Horace Underwood. We remember the martyrs. We remember the great revival of Pyongyang in 1907. We remember. We declare that 1907 revival is only a taste of what is to come for the church in Korea. Lord, you are a God who takes your people from glory to glory. We call out to you tonight and declare that the Korean people will once again taste the goodness of revival. You are going to cause deserts to bloom. Open the floodgates once again, Lord. Take over your church with your presence, with your love, and with your power. Where there were once men and women who lived in your presence and moved in your power, we now see men caught up in politics, in feuds, in struggles for power. Lord, awaken your church to see that there is more. Awaken your church to come out from under the grip of a religious spirit, and let your people be filled with your spirit so that they may walk selflessly in love and freedom. You have more for your church, and yet it has confined itself to the man-made structures of religion, politics, and bureaucracy. We reject this and declare that a new day is coming for the church in Korea. You are bringing forth a wave of your power and your presence. The church will once again take hold of your promises and live in accordance with them. Your sons and daughters will walk as heirs, as royalty, and live out lives that do even greater things than those who have gone before them. Let's pray. raising up a generation that does not know you. Where have the fathers gone? Where are the true shepherds? Our hearts are grieved as yours is. We cry out tonight on behalf of the youth of this nation, and we intercede on their behalf, calling them to their rightful place as heirs, as sons and daughters of the Most High. You alone can bring restoration and salvation. Lord, bring conviction to the older generation. Cause their hearts to break for the youth. Cause them to seek your face for the youth. Cause them to rise up as true fathers, as true shepherds that will cover the youth with your love and grace. Bring their prayers to fruition. Lord, we know that there have been prayers, but God, we speak right now that you will bring the disparity between the young and the old. You will bring it to a close. Lord, there is so much disparity. And God, we know that the Confucian mindset has eroded this culture and caused the youth and the elders to be separated out of a form of honor and respect. This mindset has caused the youth to be misunderstood and overlooked. It has caused the elders to be filled with pride and disregard for the spiritual well-being of the youth. We disallow this mindset to continue. We disallow it to erode the generations. Lord, we prophesy restoration and reconciliation over the generations of Korea. Let them have minds of Christ. Let them live by biblical principles. Let the hearts of the fathers turn to the children, and the hearts of the children turn to their fathers. We speak out grace and forgiveness. We speak out grace to forgive and grace to repent. Lord, put conviction in the hearts of fathers and in the hearts of children. Restore relationships and bring forth a great reconciliation in the church among the generations. As the fathers and sons are restored, we declare that a great harvest will come forth among the youth. Rise up, fathers. Rise up, shepherds. Look after your flock. Watch over your youth. Draw them into your arms and in the love of Christ. Let's pray.
You're bridging every gap, you're turning.
bridging every gap, you're turning every heart. You're 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 bridging every gap, you're turning every heart. Bring restoration, 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 bring restoration.
You are
your heart. Bring restoration, bring restoration.
Sing it.
You're bridging every gap, you're turning every heart
tonight.
You're bridging every gap, you're turning every heart. Bring restoration, bring restoration,
bring restoration,
bring restoration, bring restoration.
You have ordained your church here in Korea and called forth your people to follow you. You have placed your glory over this nation. Korea has been a nation close and dear to your heart. Lord, we know that your heart is grieved when you see your people living in bondage. They are walking out the motions, but many of their hearts are far from you. You are grieved when you see your bride filled with filth or far from you. Lord, we speak out a cleansing over the Church of Korea tonight. You alone can cause a hardened heart to be convicted. You alone can cause your church to rise up in holiness. We prophesy a cleansing over the church. Purge the church of evil and malice. For too long, spirits of divination, division, slander, confusion, malice, lust, and religion have been allowed to have their way among your people, causing the church in Korea to lose its saltiness and to divide from within. We bind up these spirits by the blood of Jesus and call forth your Holy Spirit to fill the church once again. Lord, cause men to put away their selfish ways and their hunger for power. Strip away ulterior motives and open their eyes to the true state of their hearts. Expose the darkness with your light. Rid the church of adultery. Rid the church of slander. Rid the church of scandal and power struggles. Rid the church of divisiveness and embezzlement. Rid the church of bitterness and unforgiveness. Jesus, you are coming back for a spotless bride. Ready your bride here in Korea. Have mercy on the church. Have mercy on the church. We do not want to see the church succumb to evil from within. Bring conviction. You are a father who cares enough to expose darkness so that we may become more and more like you. You expose darkness so that we may be freed from the shackles and healed. Expose the darkness. Bring your fire and burn up the chaff. Bring your fire and refine and purify your church here in Korea. Let your spirit wash over your church like rain, like a waterfall. Wash away all the dirt and the filth. There is no chain that your love can't break. There is no chain that your love cannot break. Raise her up, oh God. Raise her up to her true identity. Let her walk in holiness and righteousness. Let's pray.
Yeah.
you desire your people to stay in a place of rest in your presence. You gave us the example of Mary and Martha in your word. It is a relationship that you desire with us, not striving. Lord, we know that service is a good thing, but not when the heart behind it has grown cold and the desire to be with you has waned. We have seen the striving spirit over the Korean church, and we know that your heart longs for the Korean people to take a moment to just be, to rest in your presence, and know that their identity is not determined by what they do. Lord, we ask that you bind up this striving spirit by the blood of Jesus, this works-based mentality, bind it up by the blood of Jesus. Rewire the hearts and minds of the Korean church. Cause a great hunger to overwhelm the Korean church, a hunger that will cause your children to stop in their tracks and worship you. From the core of their being, cause them to cry out to you. All the expectations from the culture and the culture of the church are causing your people to slowly die on the inside. All the striving is causing your people to burn out, to lose sight of their greatest purpose, which is to love you and to be loved by you. Draw them back to their first love. Like Hosea, draw your bride into the wilderness and speak tenderly to her. Make her heart burst with passion for you. Light her fire once again. As your church is like a, let it be like a city on a hill that cannot be hidden. Let its light shine brightly. Let the sound of her be heard throughout the alleys and streets. Use her as your mouthpiece among the seven mountains. As she worships you and basks in your presence, cause your favor to fall on her and bring forth great change in this nation. Let the church rise up in glory and shift this nation to be a people that lives by the principles and the truths of the kingdom and by your word. Let your bride's hunger for you cause a surge of reformation across this nation, transforming the mindsets and landscapes, restructuring the seven mountains to be built upon and to function from your eternal word and truth. We prophesy over your bride in Korea that she is being filled with fresh hunger tonight. Let's pray.
Thank you.
respond to your love. Passionate hearts 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 respond to your love. Respond to your true love.
God, we thank you that your heart burns for Korea. We thank you that you've called us to this land, that you've given us a piece of your heart tonight for this nation, for this church here in Korea. But we thank you that we can trust that you are moving, that you are faithful to the end, that truly you will see these things to come to pass, that there is even greater glory in store for this nation, that there is even greater glory in store for your bride here, that you're refining her and that you love her, that you see her for who she is supposed to be, you see her for who you've made her to be. And so God, we thank you. We thank you that we can partner with you and that we can speak out your heart back to you. We love you, Lord, and we thank you.
You're faithful to the end, you will finish what you started. Faithful to the end, you will finish what you started. You're faithful to the end, you will finish what you started. Oh my God, you can do anything. Oh my God, too hard for you. Oh my God, you can do anything.
Yes, God, we believe that truly there's nothing impossible for you, Lord. Nothing's too hard for you, God. And there's always something in our hearts that tells us, Lord, that everything is going to be okay and everything is in your hands and everything is under control. Holy Spirit, we thank you for just your whispers of teaching us how to follow Jesus, how to follow Jesus and trust in the Father. Lord, we believe that your plans and purposes for this nation is much bigger, much greater than what we know of. And that your heart is actually really hopeful, God. You don't just see the negative things, Lord, but you know what's to come ahead. So, Lord, would you continue to pour out the revelation of your heart for this nation upon us, God, as your people. We have experienced much grace, much mercies, and much of your love, God. Your love is unshakable. So, Lord, we just trust in you and trust in the good things you have for us and for Korea. We thank you for choosing us to partake in this with you, to see revival come to Korea, to see youth coming back to the church, God, to see the generational gap all filled, God. And, Lord, we just thank you that you are renewing your bride. You are renewing the church, God. So we thank you for an amazing work of restoration you are doing. And we trust you. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for joining us tonight. I hope that you enjoyed just being in God's presence tonight. Tonight was very special. It was different. Continue to Remember that this, you can have this, like this intimacy and the closeness that you feel in this room with the Lord, His heart for you, His heart for the nations. You have access to that always. So I hope this encourages you guys. Good night.